football from the Big Apple. We're at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Ought to be a good one here between the Texas Rangers and the New York Yankees.
And now, your 2021.
It's Yankees baseball, and it comes your way next.
Your Yankees.
Nestor Cortes Jr., the Cuban-born southpaw, gets the starting nod. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be exciting. This is one of the top young pitchers in the game right now. He keeps getting better. He keeps learning. And if he continues at this pace, this guy has a chance to be one of the more reliable pitchers in the game.
Striding in is Leody Taveras. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. He'll throw down to first, one away. So bases are empty with one gone, and into bat next will be Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Fouled away. Temperature here at game time, 61 degrees. Looking for back-to-back K's to start the game.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And he fouls this one off.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
Well, when you go with a slider there on a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
Next to stand in is Adolis Garcia. High in the air out to center field. Gardner is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, Nate Lowe.
Up next for the Rangers, Nate Lowe. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Oh, and he breaks, and they've got him picked off. The tag, and he is safe on a very close play at the bag.
You know the defense wants that play back. They had him totally picked off when he took off early, but they just couldn't finish him off. We'll see if that comes back to bite him here.
Payoff pitch on its way. Kiner-Falefa at second with two down. Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Gardner. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Rangers leave one, and now the Bombers will get their shot. No score. A.J. Alexi gets the starting assignment for the Rangers in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
It's not easy as a rookie to go out there and establish yourself, get the off-speed pitches over, and just try to be the same pitcher that you were in the minor leagues. And one of the big keys, not get ahead of yourself.
And now in the box, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. One and two to DJ LeMahieu.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese, swung at and missed. Red. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Stepping in now, Brett Gardner. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And no chance at a recovery here, as despite a great effort that time, they won't get an out on the play.
Batting third, the right fielder, Aaron.
So here is Aaron Judge, and at first for him following the one-out single. Runners on first with one down. Two and one. From the stretch, swing and a liner, and that's in there, base hit, and that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
That's the cat and mouse of the game right
there. First baseman,
you find yourself count leverage, you think you're getting a heater, he throws an off-speed pitch and you're still able to execute, that fires me up right there.
Into the box now, Anthony Rizzo. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Tavares waits on it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
That is it. The designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
So now here is Giancarlo Stanton looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. Ready with the 1-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Two men are on with two men out. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. Three-run home run for Giancarlo Stanton as the Yankees move out to a 3-0 lead.
What a way to start this one off. Scoreless top of the frame, and you answer with a bomb at the bottom of the first.
So now to the plate, Joey Gallo. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Wow, these guys are really grinding out their at-bats in this one. They're not making any outs easy to get. And that, of course, is having a huge impact on the pitch count.
Fouled off. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Another look at the big blow for the Bombers, a 3-run home run. Second inning coming up. It's now 3-0 New York. Second inning set to go, and into bat next, former Dodger minor leaguer Willie Calhoun.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1.
I can't lose,
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
The 3-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. Again, he sends it out of play. Popped him up. Urshela waits on it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Batting six, the second baseman, Nick Solak.
Now at the plate, here is Nick Solak. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Batting seven.
Now it'll be Jonah Heim to work on keeping this top of the second alive. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Left fielder is on the move. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. Still down 3-0. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. 1-2, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
At the plate, Gary Sanchez. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
One out, nobody on. And it's two balls and two strikes now. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Hammered the other way to deep right field. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Batting ninth. The shortstop, number 29.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Two out, nobody on. Got him swinging, and that's the third out. 1-2-3 go the Bombers, but they lead it 3-0. Leading off the inning, it'll be DJ Peters as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Popped him up. Rizzo shading to his right, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Batting ninth,
now with the plate is Yoni Hernandez, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
It's hard to come up with any rhyme or reason why switch hitters hit from one side better than the other, but if you look at the numbers, he's not quite as successful hitting right-handed against left-handed pitching.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. A swing and a ground ball to third, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Rangers still searching for hit number one in the ballgame. Now this pitch is swung on and popped up, and this will also head toward the right side of the infield. Torres backs up and takes care of it, two away. And now Leody Taveras struck out in his last trip to the plate. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And the Rangers are in the hit column.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
At the plate now, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Now batting.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Next to hit, Adolis Garcia. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Taveras over at second. Falefa on at first with two down. And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
He'll try again, 1-2. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. After it is Gardner. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Rangers leave a pair. They trail it here 3-0. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. Hit on the ground out to short. There's Kiner-Falefa. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. One out here in the Yankees' third inning. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Bases are empty. One man out. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already. And there are two gone in the inning.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. What does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by. Brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
In now, Aaron Judge. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Taveras waits on it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They lead it 3-0. All set for the start of the fourth, and now here's Nate Lowe. Goes the other way as this is lined to left, and a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
You got to be frustrated if you're on the mound. You try and go elevated heater right there and blow some cheese by him, and he's able to scramble it and drive it the other way for a base hit. Nice job by the hitter to get the barrel to that baseball.
Into the box, Willie Calhoun fouled away. No runs, two hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. And he missed with it up and in to even things at 2-2. Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Two pitch is a fastball high, so it runs full. 3-2.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, and the Rangers have come back to cut this to a 3-2 ball game now.
Well, they were a lot more comfortable up three than they are now, only up by one. That just goes to show you one pitch, one two-run shot, and the entire complexion of a game can change just like that.
To the plate now, Nick Solak. Outside, 2-1. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Jonah Heim waits on deck. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Count still full, 3-2. Lifted down the line in left. Gallo comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Here comes the Yankee skipper on his way to the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So he will curiously make his way to the dugout after what has to be considered a very brief appearance. Albert Abreu, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Albert Abreu.
And now here is Jonah Heim, flew out last time up. Still only one out in the inning. One pitch is a curveball that misses ball two. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. DJ Peters will be next. The 3-1. Swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Popped him up. LeMahieu has room in foul territory, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Now batting.
So next to bat will be DJ Peters. 0-1 for him here in this one. Bases are empty here with two men out. High in the air out to center field. Gardner able to track it down for the third out. But two here in the Rangers half of the inning, and they come on this two-run home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Yankees 3 and the Rangers 2. just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. Now the 1-1 pitch.
That's ball two.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
He turns on it and sends it deep down the line and right. And that one is good. Solo home run here for Anthony Rizzo, and it'll give the Yankees a 4-2 lead.
No doubt if that one's fair or foul, everyone in the stadium could hear that loud doink, and that's music to a hitter's ears because that's a homer.
So now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. Now a swing and a miss, and Stanton is down on strikes for out number one.
Now batting, left field.
One out, base is empty,
Joey.
And that'll bring up Joey Gallo. Four runs, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Counts even, 2-2 to Joey Gallo.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Oh, and there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
This tells me a lot about this guy. He's done a real nice job bouncing back from that home run to strike out the next two guys. Sometimes you're going to get taken deep, but it's all about how you respond that really matters.
At the plate, Gleyber Torres. Now a swing and a fly ball. And this will wind up a foul ball. To two balls and two strikes now. Two out, nobody on. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. The Yankees do get one on the solo homer. We're through four. It's now 4-2 New York. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I talked with the Rangers manager during the inning break about the team's offensive production to this point. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. sets this one up. LeMahieu over to his right. He's got it one away.
Up next for the Rangers.
Stepping in once again is Leody Taveras. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number 5. And he fouls this one off. And this is swung on and missed, so it's 2 up, 2 down to start the 5th.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Heiner Falefa.
Into the box now, Isaiah Kiner Falefa. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1.
I'm pretty surprised by the location on those last 3 pitches. The book on him is that he hits the way pitch pretty well, and he just saw 3 in a row out there.
So does he go back out there again?
No, Matt, I expect him to mix it up. Most catchers won't call for the same location over and over and over.
Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Popped him up. Rizzo is there. And that's the 3rd out. Rangers set down in order. They trail it here 4-2. Stepping up is Gary Sanchez as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the 5th. Now the 1-1 pitch is in there for the 2nd strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
I think that curveball is a big reason why he's able to turn things around in this start after a rough beginning. It's got some good bite to it. So that tells me he's doing a nice job of snapping it off out front. Really finishing that pitch like you're supposed to.
In now, Gio Urshela. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Guess who tipped their hand? They were sitting all over a piece of cheese. He flew open on the front side.
And this is popped up. Back behind 2nd. Solak ranges back, and he has it for out number 2.
Now batting.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. DJ LeMahieu grounded out in his last at bat. Now here's the pitch. And he misses. 2-1. 2 out, nobody on. Hard hit toward the hole. And that's through for a hit. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the 2 out base hit.
Hey, Dero, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the 2-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible. And if 2-out knocks are the answer, then so be it.
At the plate now, Brett Gardner. The count now at 2-1. From the stretch. Got him to go down after that one, and it's 2-2.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those 4 pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Hernandez has a play, and he makes the catch to retire the side. The Yanks leave 1, but they still lead this one 4-2. Now to bat, Adolis Garcia. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Now batting. The first
base. Nate Lowe digging in now. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. A 2-1 count to the Rangers first baseman. To 2-2 now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full 3-2. Willie Calhoun waits on deck. The 3-2 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. On to first, and there were two down. And here's the former prize Dodger prospect Willie Calhoun. He hits with two away as they continue to trail in this close game.
Well, Matt, this has been a big inning on the mound. He's had to face the middle of the order, and so far he's held them at bay.
Yeah, this feels like the kind of inning we'll look back on at the end of the game, even if the result of it changes dramatically here. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Bases are empty here with two men out. Filthy changeup that time, but he's able to make contact and he'll get another chance. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 1-2. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Here now the 2-2. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Torres has it. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. Still down by a count of 4-2. Number 45 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
For Texas, number 45.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
That's ball three.
Just low with the slider there. That's ball three.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Oh, he had a go at one there, but this is fouled off to the right as the count draws full.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Still three balls and two strikes. The eighth pitch of the at bat on the ground to the right side, reined in, and there's one down now.
Now back, first baseman.
So one gone in the inning, Anthony. And that'll bring up the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. One out, nobody on. A ball and two strikes to Anthony Rizzo. Some movement now in that Texas bullpen as a left-hander starts to get cranking down there. Here comes the 1-2. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw in time at first for out number two.
The bat.
Giancarlo Stanton
will
stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Two out, nobody on. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. 1-2-3 go the Bombers as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. All set for the start of the inning, and that means Nick Solak will dig in. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Hit on the ground out to short. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. Next, here is Jonah Heim. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
I like how he worked him backwards for that strikeout there. He wasn't showing the fastball early in the at-bat, but then went back-to-back once he had the hitter down in the count.
Stepping in now, DJ Peters. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The next 1-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
They haven't had much luck so far tonight, so they'll definitely take that extra base hit. It only takes one, so maybe they can string together a few and get back into this thing.
Next, Yonny Hernandez. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep, but if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Two out here and a runner at second. Three and one.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Heading after it is Judge. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning.
Ladies
one left for Texas. They trail it here 4-2. Frustration boiling over with an opportunity missed. More from the Bronx after this. Digging in now for the Yankees, Joey Gallo. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. The 2-2.
Three ball, two strikes.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Fouled off. Hit pretty well out to deep left field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And the Yankees are in business here. It's a leadoff double.
Talk about starting off the inning with a bang. Goodness. When this thing left the bat, I thought it was out of here. And I think he might have, too. Only made it to the warning track, but he glides into second base with a leadoff double.
So now to the plate, Gleyber Torres. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Tavares waits on it. One out. Next for New York, Gary Sanchez. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. One and two to the Yankees catcher.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
And that misses two and two. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Gallo leads off second with one gone in the inning. He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay two and two. From the stretch, swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You could just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
To the plate now, Gio Urshela. Hard hit ball to short. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. One left for the Yankees, but they still lead this one 4-2. Chad Green has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 57, Chad Green.
Ready to begin the eighth, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Leody Taveras. Now the 1-1 pitch. Taken, strike two.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch. And he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
Standing in now, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. That's 2-2. The 2-2. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Right side. And that'll find its way into right field for a one-out single.
Sometimes you get lucky in this game. I don't think pitch recognition-wise he would choose to swing at that exact pitch. But you know what? Sometimes result is the only thing that matters.
Into the box now, Adolis Garcia. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Hey, Now a throw over, and the runner back in standing. Runner at first here, one man out. And again a throw, and he'll get back in safely. Runners on the move for second. Swing and a miss, strike three. The throw is not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely. Don't know if that was a true hit and run there with two strikes or not, but he's into second base safely on the strikeout. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Nate Lowe. For his career in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. This ball will be chopped foul. Fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. And he fouls this one off. Fouled off. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Rangers leave one, still down by a count of 4-2. So now to the plate, DJ LeMahieu. It was a base hit last time up. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. Brett Gardner waits on deck. And here's a ball hit in the air, but this is going to wind up a foul ball.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Peters will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out. So now next to hit is Brett Gardner. He got under one and popped out his last time up. Bases are empty, one man out. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Three and two to the Yankees center fielder. The 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Up next,
here's big Aaron Judge.
The right fielder.
He's got a hit in three at bats to this point.
Judge.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Popped him up. Heim is under it. And the inning is over. So the Yanks go 1-2-3 as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Aroldis Chapman comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Aroldis Chapman.
Willie Calhoun We'll stand in again as we flash you back here to the fourth inning. This was a two-run home run that was definitely one of the big blows of the ball game to this point. The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get. But retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
One pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
And that one yanked just foul. One out, nobody on. Fastball well outside.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Texas down to their final strike in this one. And that one's taken outside for a ball. They walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
That is just a great at-bat there. When you're down late, you need base runners any way you can get them. And that never-say-die mentality could be the difference. We'll see how it plays out.
Number 37 will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 37.
One and one count. Here's the pitch. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble. 3-1.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
The 3-1 swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. A crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Man, facing Chapman is not for the faint of heart as he unleashes fireball after fireball. Gets the final out here and another save. What a weapon Chapman is.
4-2, the final score tonight. The Yanks jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Albert Abreu pitches well enough to get the W. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Yankees, 4 runs on 6 hits. No errors. They left 2 men on base.